Hi, this is John Manley, and this is my very first video book review. I've read Essentialism, The Disciplined Pursuit of Less by Greg McKeown 4 times, and I'm sure I'm going to read it many more. It's a dose of reality that offers a balance between nihilism and optimism with the words,
"You can do anything, but not everything."
The ideas presented in this book helped me write and rewrite 15 times my very first novel, Much Ado About Corona. Greg McKeown asks the question, if you could only do one thing, what would it be? And once you answer that question, now you know where to redirect your focus. As McKeown points out, for the first 500 years of its existence, the word priority was only used in the singular. There is no such thing as the word priorities. The plural form was assumed to be inherently self-contradicting, kind of like humans. Greg McKeown may at first appear as if he is asking you to evade responsibility. Instead, he is asking you to be highly disciplined by focusing on the vital few instead of the trivial many. It's about the art of learning to say no, not just to others, but to yourself as well. Sometimes what you don't do is just as important as what you do, McKeown writes. If it isn't a clear yes, then it is a clear no. The author asks, what will you want to look back on when you're lying on your deathbed? What difference did you make to others or the world at large? McKeown argues that once you give yourself permission to stop trying to do it all, to stop saying yes to everyone, only then can you make your highest contribution towards the things that really matter. But essentialism doesn't rush you into the life of an essentialist. It actually encourages a period of playful exploration, so that once you consciously choose your aims, you will not waver in your commitment to them. The next step is eliminating everything in the way. The reality is, explains McKeown, saying yes to any opportunity, by definition, requires saying no to several others. The concluding chapters focus on finding ways to make execution effortless. Well, almost effortless. For example, McKeown encourages sleep over coffee. He's actually a Mormon bishop, so I think he would go to hell if he drank coffee. Anyways, he lists examples of shocking numbers of hours many of the world's most successful people spend with their heads on the pillows. Sleep will enhance your ability to explore, make connections, and do less but better throughout your waking hours. So, if you're trying to lead a meaningful life without getting burnt out, then I encourage you to purchase, read, and reread this book. It has been essential in helping me make several big life decisions and 1,000 small daily choices. You can order Essentialism through your local bookstore or in the link below. Thank you very much. This is John Manley, author of Much Ado About Corona, available at muchadoaboutcorona.com. Thank you. See you next time.